I would like to see what the productivity is of a building is. Like, after you place it, if you affect the environment around a building, it would be nice to see what would affect it. Like, obviously, if there's a hunting tent or whatever, a hunter's camp, and then you destroy the trees around it, that should negatively affect that. Thanksgiving emotes win. We could do one. 4,000 emotes. Everything is going to be locked behind the 4,000. We're approaching Get Smart levels of locked doors. Yo, Aramo, thank you very much for the 20, dude. This came out yesterday in early access. Being rebuilt, that's nice. And apparently we have 130 stone, okay. So. After they gather all that, we're probably gonna have to build a mine. It's getting too far after that. Does it only gather within the circle that surrounded it before placed? Yeah, I don't think we can change the work area of the building. It has to be near it. Regrow these, replant. That's totally unnecessary. A player shouldn't have to continue to tell the farmers what to do. Once you assign them as a farmer, you tell them. vegetarian liking and more vegan. There should be more bears here. Sir, you are not a goat, Fritz. Day 45. They haven't noticed me. I am one with the goats. Trying to blend in. Alright, good. Looks like homes are getting built pretty quickly now. Now I'm kind of bummed about blowing like 400 coins on food that we never got. So that was basically a scam. Unless they all ate it, but everybody was still hungry after we stuff, so. So this is a stone mine. So mines are built into the ground, kind of like that. It's kind of cool how that looks, actually. Is this supposed to be an iron mine? Okay. Interesting. Interesting. Are there carts and wagons in this game? I've not seen that. Well, there are carts and wagons that you can put down for decoration, but it doesn't seem like there's an upgrade or something to build the increased transport. There are boats, though. Yeah, it looks like the one in the north is the stone mine, the one that we just built in the iron mine. Look at the people. What's up, Mohammed? How you doing, dude? I think there's only one. I don't think we can mine any other materials in the game. I think it's just iron. Although I thought there was like maybe a way to get lime for tanning or something, but it's maybe rare. It seems like the best way to find out whether or not we can hunt or whatnot is to do this. It's literally 0% lime. Nice, we made storage for these two. But we can also store things in the main building. Luckily, we have a lot of workers for planning. Turning it off doesn't, like, fire the workers. Yo, Christopher Sparrow, welcome aboard as a little raptor. Enjoy your new emotes, man. Let's get some Vikings in the chat. Let's go. Thank you very much for the big O support. Double. Things are broken, Smiley. I figured I watch all the time. I should start contributing. Love the content, Raptor. Well, thanks, Christopher. You just watching is, you know, helping the channel to grow. So thank you very much. Anything other than watching is always extra. So if you drop in to watch, thank you very much. But if you tap the like button, if you drop the super chat, if you said hi in the chat, if you join the Discord, whatever, thank you very much. We did a giveaway yesterday for City Builders. So I hope to do more giveaways in the future on the channel, so make sure you guys jump on the Discord as well. What's up, Robert? Good to see you too, man. And Never Junkie, good to see you. Oh, new people coming in. What kind of cars do Vikings drive? Yours? kind of bummed out about the whole hunting thing, but I was hoping it could be like an extra source of food and leather if I had to slaughtering all the time. I'm also not sure how we're getting wool, like, from goats. Obtained from furry animals can be used for various... Oh, so it means there must be an any type of fur then, not just wool. But I'm not sure if we get that only from slaughter, or if it's just like a passive thing. About the Viking who was reincarnated who is Bjorn again. You'll get a debt. Last time I looked, timber was... Oh, we must have set a minimum. Then we only need one person there. Well, when we start building boats, we're probably going to need a lot. So let's just do 200. Sounds crazy, but... It looks like we got plenty of firewood, plenty of planks. Yo, Brentman, thank you very much for becoming a Raptor Egg. Thank you very much for the support. Okay, so replant that. All right, so we're getting a crazy amount of grain now, but it's still not enough. All that grain is that, so I found out that it's 10 to 1. 10 grain equals 1 bread, which is crazy expensive because each granary holds 250 grain. That's 25 bread. We're building 3 granaries now. And we can probably get like 2 or 3 more harvests in before the end of the year, maybe. But like the windmill's so slow now. But I don't necessarily want to do that, I just want to spread it around. But I want to diversify our food in terms of, like, building the gathering hut, building two fishing docks, we should have fish and bread here, the gathering spring, berries and herbs, medicine, and food. And we should have meat too, but... I tried to build a hunter cabin, but it's kind of weird to like manage buildings in this game, because once you place it down, a building's productivity could drop to zero and you're not able to tell. I'm not sure. To fight out Viking raids, yeah, there seems to be the ability to build defenses and also attack. I guess we'll need all that for the bows we'll build. Hey, there we go. Okay. Lots of good food, lots of good housing. Thank you. locked me onto slow speed, so we're gonna lose the buildings, and this is a disaster. We can't speed up in time. Damn it. Alright. Here it comes. Damn you. Build it when it's over. There's some poor in this house. There's some poor in this house. Certified leak in the roof this week. Storm is busting. Oh, if you don't hit the rebuild button fast enough, it just deletes the house. Sacrifice six animals. Looks like only three houses. Maybe four here. Colliding with three. Let's see, is there a three in here? Okay. But you can't cut it down though. But hey, it's colliding with it. There's eight breads sitting at the window, right? Seems pretty peaceful so far. Yeah, so far. I mean, I'm trying to get, up to these boats. We gotta gain more fame, so that way we can get these boats going. Did no one else appreciate the impromptu WoW parody? No, usually never out. Jokes. Nobody knows. The Civil War Rise, yeah. It was prime in the game, but it's kind of done for events. Like, if they, like, shoot people down the pipe. And it'll have these really, like, harsh results, like... Two people had a slight disagreement. Do you want to execute everyone or burn down the town? Like, those are the two options. have the Strombi emote in. That must be it over there, but like, how do I know this is trade boats, or how do I know this isn't like 10% faster or something like that? Tree of life is like. Okay, that unlocked warships, that's good. So that must unlock trade ships, okay. Life needs to be redone. You should be able to see what the research will lead to, since points are limited like that. It's like you're doing research scouting. Like in order to know what's down the line, you have to buy stuff. Alright, hopefully that solves the problem there for the housing. Les meat. Les wolf. Don't mind if I do. I there's the meat, yep. Wow, we discovered Paris. I guess we should change one of these fields to barley. Not sure how much beer will be made from... If we get 250... I don't know what the ratio is for beer. I don't know if, like, 250 barley will make, you know, like, 50 beer or... It's probably 10. It's probably 10. Doing your stream of the game, decided to buy it right away. Awesome, El Magic Potato. Thank you very much. Oh, did we finish our mine? Nope. Let's build a road out of town, though. Feel like we wouldn't have enough people at the tailor meet to make clothing. Oh, we have 102 wool and only 10 leather. I think the hunter would be the best way to bring in leather, but I gotta build the hunter like on the other side of the planet. Well, let's see if we can hire one person. Since we have so much wool, maybe that'll get us leather. We need food. So let's change to barley for a year. I don't think there's any spoilage either on food. It's eaten pretty quickly anyway. I'm feeling weird energy today. What do we got for the moon going on? Actually, what's my horoscope for today? I know a lot of you were into that. What does it say? Like, 2 for one today down at Denny's or something like that. There was a blood eclipse of the moon last night, I think, or the night before. Oh, there we go. Somebody's got crystals. What's your thought on this versus Manor Lords, guys? Well, this is early access. Manor Lords was just a demo. I feel Manor Lords seems like a demo is much more. That's going to be about conquering the land slowly through diplomacy or war. And this is kind of more about building a settlement in a fjord and then trading and kind of pillaging that way. This accurately simulates a lot of things that the Vikings did. And Manor Lords will kind of be more of a tell-your-own kind of story type thing. They're both similar in many ways, but different. I'm enjoying both, though, but I really want to give some good feedback on this game. And I see there's a big old feedback button up here, but I feel like my time in the two streams that we've had, I've found a lot of issues with UI and things like that they're important issues, but I don't think there'll be a major issue that's like game-breaking. It's just, well, it's like this. You know, like the speedometer. So the UI being broken like that is the speedometer in your car being broken. Let's just say that's an easy fix, but still like a critically important piece of equipment to work correctly. But it's all kind of about what you want to do. Like Farthest Frontier doesn't let you send out raids, this game does. And Manor Lords isn't out, so you can't really, like, even the demo's not around anymore. You can't really play it. So in terms of games that are currently available, it kind of depends on what you'd like to do a little bit more. Would I recommend holding off on buying? Well, it's $18, so I feel like that's a fair price for what's here now and what could be presented in the future. But I hope some of the things change, like farming is a little strange and Tree of Life is strange with how you have to scout out. Like it's kind of cool how the Tree of Life starts at the bottom and there's kind of one path, and then it branches out into like war and trade and other things like that. But in order to see what's out there, you got to kind of like buy the resources. Like I don't know what like this is. So it's like, how would I know I want to go down that line in order to invest points, you know? It's like in, for example, God of War Ragnarok out now, right? Like, if you're going to go down a chain in that game, like, more defense or more offensive power or more, you know, I don't know, health or whatever. Like, if you're going to go down that chain, you want to see what the whole upgrade tree gives you. So that way, like, the first upgrade kind of sucks, but the second one's really good. Then you buy the sucky one just to, like, you know, unlock the prerequisite. But this one just doesn't even tell you. It's like magic going to the grocery store where everything's just in this fun surprise bag. Call that imagine someone does the grocery shopping for you if you just have to go buy mystery bags. Like, wow, you got goat cheese, raisins, and a carrot. Is this Viking Animals? I mean, it's closest Viking type game that I've played that so far. There is another one out there called Frozen that was a little different. You don't know what's further up line as a technology you learn as you go along. Yeah, true, but like what I would do then is this would make me want to do this. I would want to go to Steam and like find a screenshot of the tree or like remember what's here for next playthroughs, but I shouldn't have to do that. I don't know why it's being secretive with the upgrades. Kind of weird. I think we can't tell them what it is. now we got an astronomical amount of food for now. Now it's going to unlock more fame. So it says increased population and various events. Well, thank God we've been accepting every time people come here. Oh, it looks too bright. Yeah, so YouTube has been doing this thing where it's making videos darker and live streams darker, so I've upped the brightness. So if it looks washed out, it's mostly so everybody can see, otherwise it's way too dark. A lot of people have been saying that more and more. So whenever, you know, when you start up a new game and it'll do that thing where it'll give you three images, and it's like, make sure the image on the left is fairly visible. I just go like almost all the way. Like Calypso Protocol, it's just gonna be like pitch black. Which kind of sucks, because you want it to be immersive. Like, you want there to be dark, spooky atmosphere, but if I can see and you guys can't, I'm like, oh, chat, did you see that? And it's like, do you need rich houses for certain professions, or is it just more money? Rich houses might raise happiness. They'll take more materials and probably more complicated materials to build. Oh, nice. The warehouse is... So, let's get the tailor working finally. I'm going to hold off on building anything new until they're done with the last remaining houses and that mine. Luckily we've got plenty of stone, and since we're going to chill on the building, we'll just focus on iron making. But I don't think we can build the blacksmith. Probably away from the forestry building. Okay, so we got barley going. And it's going to be too late to plant again until next year. Winter is coming. We'll harvest the barley as soon as it's done in the whole year. We'll go down to the water bowl. They go in to clean their clothing down. if you like Osprey, you'll probably like this game too. I feel like Osprey is probably one of the best games for farming, though. Same with Farthest Frontier. They're both a little different, but I love the whole farming in that. Feel about this game? I love the concept, and I think we need some more city builders that are like this, where they kind of go to different levels. We've seen a million and a half medieval Europe games, but I like a lot of seeing different types of histories, like Egypt, the Aztecs, ancient China, Greece, that are more like this, where it's, you know, you're building some sort of a settlement that deals with different types of resources, different house styles, and religion and culture and belief systems that function differently. And so I want to see more of this, where we, you know, it's your typical cut down trees, make firewood, build roads, you know, all those things are the same, but it's also different because there's different styles to the homes and different ways that they function. Yeah, well, I want more games like this. Okay, so Winter's here, so these fields are not going to be great amount of food. Excellent. It must have been that massive slaughter we did. Oh, they're still slaughtering seven. Perfect. But I feel like this game could do a little bit more for the pieces are here, but I would love better ways to manage some of these things. Like, the farming and the animals could be done a little differently to maintain the food a little bit better, I suppose. A lot of manual clicking and stuff on my end. We have no leather either. Maybe the goats just don't give any sort of hide. I guess we'll have to do cattle. Let's pull that in.